Hello my students! From this video, we are starting a new cycle of lessons dedicated to post-exploitation. On this stage, there are a lot of things which can be implemented, but we are going to review the most frequent ones. All this time we were using Meterpreter. Now it is time to study all its useful features, and we will see the difference between Meterpreter and command line. The commands of Meterpreter are very simple, so let's try some of them in practice. I already established a session, and the first command we are going to use is help. When the command is executed, you will see the list of all main basic commands. Some commands can be used with options. To see all available options, just enter desired command with option -h. For example, let's review the options of search command, which is used to find the files. And you can see command syntax and its options. When we establish Meterpreter session, we need to know what process was used for injecting Meterpreter. Just enter getpit command. And we've got the process ID. To get the process name, execute ps command. And in the displaying list of processes, try to find desired process name. We injected Meterpreter to the user application, and this application can be terminated by user anytime. To avoid this situation, we need to migrate running Meterpreter process to another running process. This can be done by migrate command. For example, let's try to migrate our process to chrome.exe process. Just enter migrate command and desired process ID. Success! Let's make sure that migration was really implemented. And yes, it really worked. Now, let's try to gather some information about remote host. Sysinfo command can provide brief information. If you want to know a current username, execute getuid. Now we need to review all logical and physical drives. So just enter show_mount. And we have the following information. What about network settings? There are several commands available for us. They are similar to Windows and Linux commands. To display IP address and interfaces, just type ipconfig or ifconfig. To display the list of hosts which communicated with the victim's machine, enter the following command. You will see their IP and MAC addresses. If you want to see open TCP or UDP ports and corresponding services, just enter netstat command. Let's finish with network options and move to the file system. Pwd command can show you the current directory. To change the current directory, use a cd command. After the command, type desired directory. For example, like this. Let's display the content of our current directory. You can enter one of the following commands. In some situations, we may need to find some files. For example, let's try to find the files with a PDF extension. Use the following command. Asterisk means that the name of file can be any. And here is result. To download found file on your computer, enter download command. Then the path of the file on remote computer. And the path of location where the file will be stored on attacker's computer. Let's check result of operation. Meterpreter is useful utility, but in some situations we need to run system commands, which are not supported by Meterpreter. In this case, we can simply switch to shell mode. Just enter shell command, and you will see familiar Windows command prompt. To exit this mode, just enter exit command. By the way, if you want to background your Meterpreter session without its interruption, just type background command. To switch back to the session, first enter session command. You will see the list of all sessions running in background. Then execute sessions command with the ID of desired session. There are also other commands which can perform different actions. For example, they can disable mouse on remote host, make a screenshot, record video or audio. I recommend to study and test all of the commands. Meterpreter supports different scripts which can perform many interesting things. To see all available scripts, just open a file manager and go to the following directory. And there is a list of all scripts available for Meterpreter. You can open any file to read what functions it can perform. For example, let's consider the situation when you want to enable remote desktop on the compromised machine. If you know Windows commands, it's not a problem for you. But there is another solution. You can simply run getGUI script. Let's see how it works. I already have Meterpreter session with escalated privileges. Now run the following command. Given script has two features. It can create a new user account. And it can enable remote desktop. Well, let's enable remote desktop and create a new user. The command looks like this. Let's try remote connection. I'm connecting from another Windows machine. Here, I'm using credentials that were used in Meterpreter. And I'm connected. Let's open command line terminal to make sure that we are connected to the right computer. Please pay attention on command prompt and IP address. And here is the list of some useful and helpful scripts. As you already noticed, all Meterpreter scripts are deprecated and step by step move to the post modules. Let's do the same operation, but this time with the post modules. And I'm going to use this one. From the description, you can see it implements the same actions like the previous script. There are two ways how to run post modules. In the first method, we need to background current Meterpreter session. Then, we select appropriate post module, set all required options, and simply execute it with run or exploit command. In the second method, we can run any post module directly from Meterpreter session. Just type run with the name of module. Then, you need to define all necessary options like this. On the same machine, I am creating new user. And you can see the same output as before when we use the script. Because Meterpreter scripts are deprecated, they are no longer supported and developed. Instead, there are a lot of post modules. It's up to you what kind of tool to use, Besides, if you are familiar with the Ruby programming language, you can create your own scripts and post modules using Meterpreter and Windows API.